Hello, welcome. As usual, let's dive into the video you all love, compiling the progress reports of the major emulation projects that happened in July. But since this is a long video and I don't want to keep interrupting you, please leave a like so YouTube can recommend this hard work to even more people. If this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to keep up with all the updates. Starting with something unprecedented, Shad PS4 has been showing significant improvements, and now allows complex games like the first Red Dead Redemption to reach in-game status. The most incredible part is that even a more portable-oriented hardware like the Steam Deck can lead the game to the initial screen. Although this is a great achievement, it is still not possible to progress in the game, as some objects, like buildings, do not render correctly. It took an RTX 4090 and an i9-13900KS to keep the game at 24 FPS. If you're wondering if these will be the requirements when the project reaches a stable stage, the answer is no. The project is expected to improve its accuracy and the way things work and are emulated, and these requirements are likely to decrease as the project evolves. But that's not all. It is also possible to render Kingdom Hearts 2.8, although, like many early stage projects, the rendering is upside down. Shenmue 2, since the last version, is already rendered correctly and seems to be in a playable state. Recently, gameplay of Tomb Raider Remaster has also started to appear, rendering very well in both the original and remastered textures. However, the game cannot yet be considered playable as the gameplay is accelerated. Remember, version 0.1.1, which is the version capable of rendering 3D games, is not yet publicly available. Another unprecedented news that the channel hadn't reported until now, last week, the developer of Sudachi, Jared, posted some images on the social network X, formerly Twitter, stating something that is no surprise to anyone. The Nintendo Switch emulator for Android called Nushu is nothing more than CU with rebranding. He showed a screenshot with code similarity exceeding 89%. And the accusations don't stop there. The dev of Yuzui Phoenix responded to a post I made reporting this accusation and ran a check on Nushu, finding over 20,000 lines of code where they didn't even change the name CU in some strings. And it doesn't end there. Jared claims that Yuzui is also a copy of Sudachi, although he can't determine how much was copied. What a drama, my friends. Although I don't know how much of this can be considered true and how much is just emu drama, I can say with absolute certainty that Yuzui is performing better on Android, as tested in the video I'll leave for you to watch after this one, and which will also be in the description. In my opinion, as I mentioned in a post responding to Phoenix, the only way to get the truth about this matter is if Yuzui has public development, where anyone can see what is really being done. I still think Yuzui had relevant additions to the project, such as even lower accuracy and allowing the app to run in benchmark mode to further improve performance, but it still has issues like higher memory consumption than Sudachi. But everyone knows what is best for their project. Still talking about Yuzui, the project was banned from Discord, along with all other projects derived from Yuzu emulators. It probably received a DMCA request from Nintendo. I did a quick search on the internet and the project's official website, and I couldn't find any new Discord for this community. So, if Phoenix comes to this video and posts the link to a new Discord, Telegram, or any community, I will leave the link in the video description for you to follow the development closely. The waves of bans didn't stop there. Still, in the middle of this month, several projects had their GitHub accounts banned, including Sudachi and Torzu. Many people contact me daily looking for new or old versions of Sudachi for download. For those who want to find versions of Sudachi for Windows, Jared made a small website where you can find the project's source code and the latest compiled version for Windows. The link will be in the video description, or if you prefer, it's in the last pinned comment on our Discord. There are also rumors that Torza has returned, but it has not returned to being a public project. It is developed only on the blog of the person responsible for the project, but he changed the repository, and at the moment, it is only possible to obtain the Windows version. I will also leave the official website to get the project directly from the developer. Remember that Torzu is developed on the deep web. Although there are no reports of malware, use it at your own risk. As one of the biggest events of this month, we have the release of PCSX2 2.0. This new milestone brings many automations, such as automatic controller configuration without needing to map button by button. Additionally, API selection has become more accurate, allowing the emulator to choose the API that will provide the best visual quality without the user having to test between various options. There were also performance improvements in several games, including the Need for Speed series, Ace Combat, and Tomb Raider. The old problem of ghosts appearing when increasing the resolution scale in various games has been fixed, among many other improvements. For those who want to know exactly what these improvements were, I will leave a video in the card and description for you to watch after this video. Android received an emulator that was much needed, a CMU version. It seems that this project had been in development for some time but had not yet been released to the public because its initial state was very precarious. However, a compiled version was recently leaked, and after some tests, the state was indeed very precarious, with most games not displaying the correct colors and much less running at a decent frame rate. However, in a few days, there was an improvement created by the developer Mr. Purple, the same dev who has been updating the Turnip drivers for Snapdragon. This new version, although still experimental, brought more performance, improvements, and greater compatibility with games. Although it is not yet an ideal version, as many of the recompilers used are still for Windows, it is worth experimenting with the project to get an idea of what this emulator will be like in the future. The link to download the version of CMU created by Mr. Purple will be in the description, and if you want to know how to install the project, just watch the video in the card. Another project that may be very close to arriving on Android is Ryujinx. Although nothing has been confirmed yet, the project is implementing various functions so that the emulator can run on ARM systems. For now, the focus of these implementations is to make the project compatible with new computers with ARM processors, but once everything is implemented and working, it will be much easier to make it compatible with Android, as these devices run on this architecture. Now, a piece of news not entirely related to emulation but sure to please the nostalgics. A project has been developed from scratch, bringing to life the best fighting game for Sega Genesis so far, which is a port of Ryo Bout Fatal Fury Special. Although it is not yet a complete version, being called Light 2 with new characters to be ported in the future, the game already works very well. Yesterday, I played it to the end, and the only point that seems different from the original game is the CPU difficulty. The CPU practically defends everything and punishes almost all your jumps with anti-airs, which doesn't happen in the original game. Other than that, the sound is very good, with almost the same voices as the arcade. The audio is excellent within the limitations of the Sega Genesis, and there are some stages different from the original since porting the original stages can be very challenging due to the Sega Genesis color palette. This game will work on any original Sega Genesis hardware through EverDrive, and for those who want to test it on emulators, the recommended ones are Fusion and Blastem. Gens doesn't handle the bank switch well, and RetroArch doesn't get past the initial screen. For those who want to try the project, I leave the link to the video where you can download the project directly in the description. One of the most recent events, reported in the last video posted on this channel, is that CMU, the classic Xbox emulator, finally showed signs of progress after more than a year without significant updates. Its last major innovation was the implementation of a save state-like function, but now they have started to implement the Vulkan API. In preliminary tests, the Vulkan API can already triple the emulator's performance, although it is still in the early stages and needs some improvements before it becomes public. Will we have this new version to test in the coming days, or will we need to wait another year? Finally, Xenia, the best Xbox 360 emulator for Windows, Xbox Series, and even Android, received a third-party user interface. This interface, called Xenia Manager, now allows you to have per-game configurations without manually creating TXT files. Additionally, Xenia Manager gathers all your games in one place, making it easier to install updates and DLCs and automatically download patches to improve the games. To make it even better, Xenia Manager could have a database to download the best configurations automatically, like PCSX2. If you don't use Xenia Manager yet, you should install it now. The link to the project's GitHub, along with the installation tutorial, is in the description and the card. And that was the news roundup, folks. I hope you enjoyed it, thanks for watching, and see you in the next video. You